Part 2, Three Romantic Themes of Indian Painting, Baramasa, the six seasons and some of their main festivals. Now there are hundreds of festivals in India. Different parts of India celebrate different things, but the ones that are presented here are those that have been chosen by the painters for the most part. The seasons, the six seasons of the year and their holy days, their festivals. This is actually a calendar, including lots of pictures, little graphics, animals and deities representing various aspects of the Hindu year, 1871-2. Hindu folk astrology, the changing seasons romanced in pictures, all originally folk traditions. Romancing the various times of the year has been a pastime by many poets since the medieval era. It's gone so far as to find each season very romantic, and paintings of later centuries followed suit. The most famous of the early writers was the 7th century poet and playwright Kalidasa, who wrote remarkable descriptions of the six seasons and the feelings that people have about them, called Baramasa, Baramasa, Songs of the Seasons. His book, called Meghdoot, is well known and includes the Baramasa. Meghdoot means cloud messenger. Sri Aurobindo mentions him. He says, Kalidasa's Seasons is perhaps the first poem in any literature written with the express object of describing nature. This painting is almost more of a treatise on nature than it is on human society. Sri Aurobindo actually wrote in his epic book, Savitri, book 4, canto 1, very lyrically and well about different parts of nature's wonders. Shows that he is well versed in Kalidasa's writings, as were the painters of the images that we'll be seeing. Then in the 1400s and 1500s, two Sikhs each wrote a Baramasa, Guru Nanak and Guru Arjan. The last one is included in the sacred Sikh text, the Guru Granth Sahib, the sacred writings of the Sikhs. But at this early date, paintings were not included as illustrations of these texts. That came in the next couple centuries or so. Baramasa literally means 12 months, so it would be songs of the 12 months. The vivid descriptions of nature's beauty, even with a mystic flavor often, inspired painters to illustrate later copies of the works. Finally, the 16th century poet Keshav Das wrote the most well-known Baramasa. This is an illustration of that, the month of Pausha, but done in the late 1700s when miniature painters were getting going on illustrating the ancient texts. More toward the rainy season here, a woman pining for her absent husband, her arms out above her head, hands clasped. This is a common convention for love's longing. Keshav Das' Baramasa is a delightful account of daily life, rituals, and festivals of the seasons, of North India, though, not of the South. I'll be reading several poems from that which go together with the visuals. For tourists nowadays, India has three seasons, cool, hot, and monsoons. But it depends on where in India. Five seasons in the Himalayas. Seasons in India largely revolve around water, rainfall, so are livelihoods of the people. Agriculture, fishing, transportation, festivals, sports, and rituals all depend on seasonality. This shows the summer monsoons, not the winter ones. A very interesting chart here. On the left is the water calendar, with only four seasons revolving around the monsoons. Then in the middle, Akbar the Great's Mughal version of the four seasons based on temperature. Hot, rainy, cold, and hot. And on the right, the Indian calendar of six seasons. The 12 months and the six seasons, or Ritu, and based on the experience of living in the plains of North India. Notice how the 12 Gregorian calendar dates in the center relate to the 12 Indian months over on the left. So the six seasons, each 2 months long, are the spring, in Sanskrit, Vasant, summer, Grishm, monsoons, Varsha, early autumn, Sharat, late autumn, Hemant, and the winter is Shisir. In different regions of India, the names differ, of course. Our six-season progression will follow this chart, beginning at the top with the last part of Vasant, and ending at the bottom with the first part of Vasant. The latter part of springtime, the month of Chaitra, Vasant, will end with the early spring month of Palguna, dancing, festivities, and lots of flowers. And we will deal with the major Hindi festivals in paintings, certainly not all of them. Krishna, a major focus here, and the rains come down. This is one of the oldest paintings of spring, part of a quite unique scroll, over 36 feet long, based on the Vasanta Vilasa, an anonymous poem on spring from the 1400s, written in Gujarati, not Sanskrit. It's filled with poems and illustrations celebrating springtime. This is when Kama, god of love, evokes passion in the hearts of all. In 84 verses, lush verbal imagery evokes the beauty of spring, and the paintings closely follow the text, Gujarati style with Jain influence. This picture was painted to portray what Keshav Das had written about this season in his Songs of the 12 Months. Lovely creepers are in bloom, blossoming trees are young once more, and streams and lakes are full of flowers. Women, aglow with passion, dressed in their best, abandon themselves to sports of love. The parrot, the maina, the koel birds are singing songs of love. Such joy in the month of Chaitra, my love. Springtime means flowers, trees, flowering trees especially. Couples tend to flower as well, like Radha and Krishna. Love is definitely in the air. One main festival celebrated during Chaitra is Gudi Padua. Gudi commemorates the victory of Lord Rama over Ravana and his coronation as king after returning to Ayodhya. Every year people raise a flag known as Gudi as a symbol. So this springtime festival also celebrates the love of Rama and his wife Sita, whom he rescued from Ravana. This day also marks the ending of one agricultural season with its harvest and the beginning of a new one, and is seen as New Year's Day. Gift-giving is seen here too, giving to the common people. Sita, seated upper left, and Rama, upper right with his brother, are giving away possessions. The intense feeling of Vasanta is expressed in the following poem, where the cock sings the musical mode called Vasanta the Spring. In the garden made for play, swarms of bees are keen on the scent of flowers and fresh leaves. The god Chakra buzzes at their head. That is Vasanta. It represents the spouse of Kama, the god of love. And he has started great laughter in the turmoil of all the musical instruments in the company of women. The spring puts on the shape of Krishna. That is the song that she sings along with all her companions. In unparalleled color, mangoes are in flower, and resting upon them, there are swarms of deep murmuring bees. Women sport in delight beside their lover lord, Krishna, and he sings with the voice of the kokila bird. Grishm is the summer season, hot and hotter, from late April, May to most of June. The months are Vaisakha and Jyestha. This is the hour of cow dust, days of fever, cows going out in the morning. Trees begin to burst with new life, however. Focus on Krishna. Sandstorms, heat and dust, no big festivals, just survival. Called the hour of cow dust too, this painting, cows returning in the evening. Hot winds bring sand and dust in the air. People head to swimming holes or pools or disrobe, trying to keep cool. Water pots used for flotation. A good time to sit and meditate, do nothing much. A quiet group of ascetics wearing not much. Animals hide in caves or under the trees, crowding together. New leaves and blooms appear on trees during Grishm, usually scarlet, orange, and yellow flowers. Elephants trumpet out of stress. A fever here personified attacking the elephant. There is scorching heat until the rains come. Everyone longs for them and the rainy season. In Rajasthan, the festival of Gangaur is the most important local event, with boating on the river Chambal. It's by the palace at Kota in the background. Raja appears twice in the picture as Krishna, with his wife as Radha at the bottom of the picture and in the boat on the river, both with halos. It's a harvest event in Rajasthan, and women make offerings to the goddess Gaur, or Parvati. Some dance around her image as she goes in procession outside the walls of the city, Jaipur here. She's just right of the center. This is a hot but very auspicious time for unmarried youth to find their life partners and for married women to pray for the welfare, health, and long life of their spouses and for a happy married life. Keshav Das describes the hot month of Jyestha. Air, water, sky, earth, and fire. These elements become one, a burning fire. Weary feels the wayfarer, and tame is the wild elephant, seeing the dried-up pond. The cobra nestles in his trunk, and the tiger slumbers in his shade. All creatures of earth and water are feeble and know no rest. That is why the wise say, do not leave home in Jyestha. Rains are needed. They are lifeblood. And this poem by Rabindranath Tagore. The rain is held back for days and days, my God, in my arid heart. The horizon is fiercely naked, not the thinnest cover of a soft cloud, not the vaguest hint of a distant cool shower. Send the angry storm, dark with death, if it is thy wish, and with lashes of lightning startle the sky from end to end. But call back, my Lord, call back this pervading silent heat. It is still and keen and cruel, burning the heart with dire despair. Let the cloud of grace bend low from above, like the tearful look of the mother on the day of the father's wrath. Then the clouds come. They come in and come, and everyone points to the approaching storm. Thanks to the gods, this begins Varsha, monsoon season, late June through July to the most of August. The months are Ashada and Shravana. Dark black clouds roll in with lightning and thunder and a fury of wind over the parched earth. Everyone will need to take shelter soon. Lightning is especially dramatic, juxtaposed with flocks of birds, very erratic. A season for lovers, taking shelter from the rains, rejoicing. The inscription on this painting is, with her touching her lover, she watches the dark gathering clouds from the top of the house, restless and shining like a streak of lightning. Sometimes she moves on, and sometimes she stops suddenly. Swings are typically set up from trees for enjoyment between the torrential rain showers. Pretty clothes, swinging and singing, all ages. Krishna and Radha stay inside when it pours, but watch the lightning with glad anticipation. Musicians serenade them from down below. Romance is definitely in the air. The patter of raindrops falling adds very much to the mood. Back outside between storms to watch the lightning, which helps ignite their love for each other. In some areas, Himachal Pradesh especially, the festival of Teej happens now in the month of Shravana, the swing festival. Teej is actually a little bug that appears after the rains have come. A Maharana of Udaipur is being dressed for this joyful Teej festival. They get him ready for the swinging. A great busyness is in the air. Puja rituals in the morning. People go out and buy new clothes. Girls apply red henna to their hands, especially foods are prepared too. Singing and dancing in the evenings. Teej focuses also on Parvati, the wife of Shiva, a procession here with horses in a rural area. So people make offerings to her and worship the great goddess, a more elegant procession here with elephant. Her image is being carried there on the right. Teej is also known as Ganesh Chaturthi in other areas, and worshipping Shiva's elephant-headed son is in order. Ganesh, the remover of obstacles, especially for the monsoon season, the Varsha. Keshav Das is definitely the poet here. I will just call him the poet from now on. The streams look so lovely as they rush to meet the sea. The creepers enchant the eye, embracing young trees lovingly. The lightning flashes restlessly as she sports with rolling clouds. The peacocks with their shrill cries announce the mating of earth and sky. All lovers meet in this month of Shravana. Sharat, the season of Sharat, Sharad, meaning early autumn, late August, all of September, and most of October. The months are Bhadra and Ashvin. Swans and peacocks symbolize love. The poet writes, "The purple clouds are gathering, the thunder rolls and rain pours in torrents. The wind blows fiercely, the cicadas chirp, the lions roar, and dark wet elephants fell the trees. The day is dark like the night, and one's own home is the best." People see wild animals more now, as it is said, and their lives are disrupted by the weather. But they need and welcome the rains too. Ferocious beasts of all kinds, supposedly. Get your bow and arrows for protection. The excitement of drama in the forest, and very soon a grand festival. Dasara. This is the great festival of this season. It's also called Navaratri, Dusara, Durga Puja, very diverse in different parts of India. Romancing the many episodes of the Ramayana, it celebrates the victory of Rama, the long tale of the victory of good over evil. It certainly is a favorite of painters in any case. Lord Rama defeated Ravana, and Ram's triumphal return to his kingdom after 4 long years away. Many paintings tell the story. It tells of the rejection, expulsion, and redemption of Rama, the prince of Ayodhya. Here Rama and his wife Sita and supporters are headed to the forests of the south of India in exile. Suddenly, Sita was abducted by the evil Ravana of Lanka, using one of his many arms. Quite an outrage. He has 10 heads, too, therefore must be very intelligent. Ravana refused to return Sita to Ram, and installed her in his palace in Sri Lanka. They are waited on here by a demon. So Ram, with his loyal friends and Hanuman and his monkey army here, prepare to cross over the sea to Lanka. They all confer at the right and prepare to attack the 10-headed Ravana on top of the castle with his demon servants. This festival, Dusara in Sanskrit, means taking away 10 sins. 10 heads, 10 sins. And the forces of good, the monkey army here, defeats the evil monsters of Ravana. He oversees it all from above, upper right. The 10 heads of Ravana represent 10 sins, and Rama will destroy them all. The battle between them, Rama as Vishnu and his brother Lakshmanan overcome the evil Ravana. These are scenes of this season called Sharat. Rama, along with his younger brother, killed all the demons, and their king, Ravana, with his 10 heads, and Ram regained Sita. Heads of Ravana lay about in the field. Here they are reunited with Ravana's fortress burning in the background. And so Ram, Sita, Lakshmanan, and Hanuman finally arrive back in Ayodhya, and they are formally crowned. Hanuman prays to them here. All things get better for them from now on. And so the 10 sins of everyone should be abolished during this festival with prayers and offerings, thus to follow the path of virtue and goodness for the year. Effigies of Ravana are set up in this festival, and Rama, Lakshman, and Sita arrive to shoot arrows of fire at the effigy, and it suddenly explodes. Fireworks and general festivity prevail. A grand public display, as here at Murshidabad. And more private fun with lots and lots of fireworks. And lovers can go to more serious, very personal business after Dasara, in the month of Ashvin. The poet says this, "The spirits of the ancestors come, do propitiate them. The past rushes to my brain, oh my love. The skies are clear, the lotus is in bloom. The nights are illumined by the moon. Each couple represents Lord Vishnu and his consort Lakshmi, and are lost in their dance celestial. In this month of Ashvin, the time of love. This season of Sharat is very much loved by all." The season called Hemant runs from late October through November into most of December. It's late autumn or early winter. The months are Kartika and Agahana. The skies are clear and birds are everywhere. Swans migrate from the mountains to the plains at this time, frolicking and mating. The poet writes, "Woods and gardens, rivers and lakes, the earth itself and heavens above, all are clear and shining bright, as if illumined by a million lamps. The days and nights are full of joy, and couples are gambling. The walls and courtyards in every home are gay with paintings. The universe is pervaded with celestial light. All men and women are gay with love. The highlight festival of this season is Diwali, just 20 days after Dasara, celebrated for 5 days in some places. Diwali, or Deepavali, means a row of clay lamps. It is a festival of lights. So cleaning and whitewashing of houses is done. Decorative designs, rangoli or kolam designs, are painted on floors and walls. People buy brightly colored clothes, all new, and family members and relatives gather to offer prayers, distribute sweets, light up their homes, and play games. The central woman plays with a yo-yo as she glances back at her lover, watching her from up above. Lakshmi, as wife of Vishnu, is honored on the third day by visiting her temple or shrine, placing little lights, Lakshmi Puja. Her wealth and prosperity, then, should remain all year. Or in areas where Durga is worshipped as wife of Shiva and mother of Ganesh, it is Durga Puja, especially Bengal. Ganesh, of course, is also worshipped. The Hindu calendar marks Diwali as the darkest night of the year. Small candles are lit at dusk outside every home, even the poorest, and processions of gods and goddesses. Fireworks in the evening. And major illuminations and fireworks celebrations occur in large towns and cities like this in Lucknow. As the poet writes about the second month of Hemant, "Of all the months, God finds Agahana most dear. This is the month for happiness and salvation of the soul. The river banks are covered with flowers, and joyous notes of swans fill the air. The days are neither cold nor hot. How lucky to be together, my love, this lovely month of the year." And now the season of Shisir. It means full winter, from late December, January, to most of February. The months are Pausha and Magha. Lovers have to keep warm during the coldest month, building fires. As the poet writes, this is the month of Pausha, when no one likes cold food, light clothes, and chilly places. The skies and the earth breathe cold. In this month, everyone, whether rich or poor, wants to have six things. They are oil massage, warm clothes, beetle, sunshine, company of young women, and a warm hearth. The days are short and nights are dark and long, and this is the month for love. A big festival during Shisir is Pongol, a major 3 to 4 day event, especially in the south. In the middle of January, parades and lots of fireworks in some cities. It means winter solstice, the end of the Indian winter. Celebrated elsewhere as Makara Sankranti. Kolam designs are created by girls and women in front of homes and public buildings using white powder of various kinds. Different patterns symbolize different wishes or prayers. As symbolic lotuses, kolams can represent Lakshmi herself, the goddess of prosperity, beauty, and abundance, or it can represent a good marriage, ask for a prayer for children. 7 lotus circles, or kamalban, along with suns, moons, parrots, fishes, and an elephant, all symbolic of the goddess. Pongal is known as Makar Sankranti in other parts of India and marks the beginning of the rice harvest season. Ritual pujas are always done, involving fire and prayers, celebrations at temples and shrines of Lakshmi, or at temples of Agni, the god of fire, in some regions. Food offerings are made and returned as prasad, having been blessed by a priest. Offerings of flowers is important in this season, from the Raja to his lady in this case, dancing with Krishna in the upper background. Great public events in cities feature local rulers and public officials in procession at night, horses and elephants, and fireworks, of course. In many rural areas, lamps and candles are lit at night outside villages. So fertility and new life are celebrated with bonfires, cooking special rice and sweets, singing and dancing, exchanging greetings. And individual fireworks, of course, sparklers. Pongal is the only Hindu solar festival. The others are based on the lunar calendar. The darkest night lit up with joy. In Gujarat, this season includes a kite-flying festival. As the end of winter there, kite flying. Kites flying, kites flying. As the poet says about the month of Magha in this season of Shisir, forests and gardens echo the notes so sweet of all the birds, the peacocks, the pigeons, the koels, and the papiha bird. Endless is the humming of bees. The air is scented with musk, camphor, and sandal. Music is heard all through the night, and all celebrate the coming of Vasanta. Our last season, and the month of Palguna. Again, springtime, through March into most of April. Flowers of all kinds return in the meadows or on the trees. Golden mustard flowers, scarlet flame of the forest, and orange ashoka trees, mauve bauhinias, yellow mangoes, dancing and gaiety. Gaiety and dancing, more. Pairs of birds, luxuriant foliage. Krishna. Now is when the most colorful festival of all occurs, called Holi. It is celebrated when the fields are in full bloom and people are expecting a good harvest, mainly in the north of India. In celebrating Holi, many people gather for joyous partying, music and singing songs of spring, and tossing colors at each other. As a festival of colors, people squirt colored water on each other, or colored powders. Guys versus girls here, Radha and Krishna. smearing faces, tossing curds or yogurt. The rowdies have their day here. Or they smear each other's faces with gulal, a red dye mixed with mica. Some celebrations are more formal and accompanied by musicians. Springtime, Vasant, the most loved season by everyone, by painters too. And of course the poet writes. All restraint is gone. The rich and poor mix together and make merry. Speech is free and there is no sense of shame. Young men and women in every home play holy, smearing each other with colors, and fragrance of scented powders fills the air. Palguna, the month for merrymaking. The government of India has even issued stamps honoring the different seasons and months. The month of Pausha in the season of Hemant, the month of Jyestha in the hot season, Grishm, and the season of Vasant, spring, with its musical ragini, Basanti, and Varsha, with the monsoons, with its raga, Megh Malhar, ragamalas, garlands of melodies. Which brings us to the last DVD, Ragamala, Garland of Melodies. They are paintings illustrating music, that is, male ragas and female raginis, seen, however, as paintings, most fanciful.